Before I got to Europe, I'd never seen an aeroplane in real life. High above, they twisted and turned like flocks of birds dancing. There was a romance.
in peace. Enemy fire! Enemy fire!
The bird was busted. She buried her nose in no man's land a half mile due west of where I went down. Wilson, the poor sap, didn't make it out. But that was his bad luck. I had more pressing problems. Glad I still had a way with the old Barker. After plugging a few German stormtroopers, I was on my way west, heading back towards our side of the line. Between me and the British front were German trenches and German guns. Oh, and half the population of Berlin. All spoiling for a fight. Day. The Brits must have been sitting down for tea and crumpets instead of shelling the Germans. Still, I had to get to the other side of the line before those guns started up again.
Oh!
Schnittisch!
Those trenches were packed full of the Kaiser's finest. But hopefully, most of them would be looking for trouble coming the other way. Hopefully.
Los.
Nur weil ich das Beste für unser Land will, bestraft mich der Hauptmann ständig. Was ist daran falsch, hä?
Nein. Das Oberkommando spielt das Thema runter. Aber ich habe einen Freund, der im Hauptquartier arbeitet. Und der sagt, es gibt ernste Bedenken, weil einer unserer Frontabschnitte wegen ihnen brüllt.
Come on.
The dozen German machine guns at my back kinda encouraged me to keep my head down. No Man's Land was a maze of barbed wire, dead bodies, and debris. But I held my course. Did anything survive the crash that might be useful?
Wilson, we're in No Man's Land. We need to go now.
I can't get up.
Shit.
Hey.
I'm sorry.
But you promised to give me fucking one piece.
Just keep it down.
What about medals? What about being heroes?
I'm no hero.
But you gave me your word. Your bleeding word. So either you're a decent bloke who's gonna help me, or you're a lying, no good bastard. You'll look me in the eye and finish it! Blackburn. You're not George Rackham, are you? Son of the fourth bloody Earl of Windsor. How naive do you think I am? Oh.
Let's get out of here.
The guy was losing a lot of blood. I didn't have much time to get him back.
This is your bloody fault.
The Germans aren't really known for giving up.
MGs are trained on them. Shoot anything. We're nearly home. We made it. We made it.
Wilson said I was a no-good, lying son of a bitch. I brought him home because I think he's probably right. And I hate that fact more than I can tell you.
Hearing that man through No Man's Land? This guy's a bloody hero!
No, he's nothing of the sort. He's a cheat, a thief, and a liar. And he'll answer for his crimes.
That's right, Blackburn.
To the farm, are you?
I'm gonna speak up for you, you know, at the court martial. It might do you some
good. I doubt
good.
It, but thanks.
Wilson, with me, I need a gunner.
Over here, I'll do it. Bracken, let me help.
You don't deserve to fly.
Wilson, if I'm gonna die, I'm gonna die up there.
Come on, let's do this.
You sure you don't want to sit this one out?
Not a chance. You owe me a bloody medal.
All right, I got this. Are you with me?
Of course I'm bloody with you! Fighters on their way! I'll cover our tail!
Thank you. many more targets. Hang on!
Keep it down!
Every German on this damn balloon's gonna hear you.
Story. A selfish man who risked his own life to save another, and in doing so, found he was saved himself. Things get mixed up in wartime, though, and you'll probably hear other versions. A rogue pilot who stole a plane, who killed his buddy, then lied, cheated, and murdered his way across half the Western Front, only to escape court-martial in the chaos of an air raid. But don't listen to any of that. What you heard from me is the truth. I wouldn't tell you if it wasn't. Would I?
Everyone was affected by the war. Every corner of the world was touched.
you all right? We're ready for you to cut the cake. Wow, these are incredible.
Yes, it was an incredible time.
You looked very handsome in that uniform.
That's not me, that's Matteo.
Oh, of course. I'm sorry, Dad. Take as long as you need.
No, no, it's okay, tesoro. It's time I told you what happened to him. It was during our last battle together, just a few days after our 21st birthday. My brother's battalion had been ordered to capture a fort deep into enemy territory. I wasn't going with him. I was part of a special unit with a different mission. Our task was to support Matteo's battalion. We were a proud unit. We changed the war for Italy. The Arditi.
Oh, la vittoria! Oh, tutti accoppati!
Distruggiamo quel cadavere campano!
While Matteo was pushing forward, I had to fight up the mountain and take out anything targeting his unit.
Just hearing this story makes me worry for you.
Don't worry. I was in a full suit of armor. Besides, the Arditi were proud volunteers. We would have done anything for Italy. A church was sitting at the base of the path. Enemy troops had fortified it. I had to fight them first. Troops were some foot soldiers. After that, the church would be ours.
Busy. Andiamo a muoverci!
There was an artillery gun that was shelling us and Matteo's unit. I had to destroy it.
And he was still heading to the fort?
Right. I had to make sure he got there.